Support for WRCJ is provided by Margot European Day Spa on Townsend Street in Birmingham. What would change if you really took care of yourself? Everything. That's why Margot of Margot European Day Spa invites listeners to take better care of themselves and their loved ones for Valentine's Day. Visit margots.com for a full range of gift-giving and life-enhancing ideas.
Sunday evening at 6 o'clock here on WRCJ, Film Classics will present music by Thomas Newman, who just received his 14th Academy Award nomination for the score he composed for 1917, and his father Alfred, who won 9 Oscars and was nominated 43 times for the Golden Statuette. I'm your host, Jack Goggin, inviting you to join us for a program we're calling Son and Father on Film Classics. Sunday at 6 p.m. right here on 90.9 FM WRCJ Detroit.
And good evening, everyone. I'm going to call to order the January 27th Shelby Township Planning Commission meeting. Secretary Moore, will you please call the roll?
Mr. Dallow, absent. Ms. DeSico?
Here.
Ms. Gonzalez?
Here.
Mr. Meredith, absent. Mr. Appone?
Here.
Mr. Flynn?
Here.
Chairman Moffitt is absent. Acting Chairman Turner?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Thank you. First item tonight is our approval of our agenda.
So move.
Support.
Moved and seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Motion carries. Approval of our minutes from January 13th, 2020.
So move.
Support.
Moved and seconded. All in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries. Tonight we have 4 site plans. First is site plan number 19-44 for Maria DiAgostini for DiAgostini Land Company. It's vacant land located on the east side of Shaner, north of 23 Mile Road, 2 industrial buildings. The applicant is here. Come on down. Let us know what they'd like to do.
Hello. I'm James DeRocher, and this is Maria DiAgostini representing DiAgostini Land Company. As you can see, we are proposing 2 industrial/commercial buildings on the east side of Shaner, just north of 23 Mile. The adjacent buildings to the north are 3 multi-tenant industrial buildings that exist currently, and to the south is a retail shopping center. The two buildings that we are proposing, one is 20,800 square feet and the other is 8,800 square feet.
That's it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Julie, we'll ship it over to you for your report.
This proposal, the site plan, is consistent with what's in the area now, Chairman Moffitt. The parcel is approximately 11.7 acres, and it's connected. It's currently connected to the shopping center rights.
So the 11.7 acres includes the southern portion of the parcel, which is not pictured here. It has the Deer Creek Shopping Plaza that has the McGall's restaurant. The portion of the parcel at issue for developmental purposes is this upper portion, which is about 4.0.
It's roughly 4.1 acres, I believe.
Let me give you this. If you're going to speak, we need to make sure you're, if I can get this to work. Here we go. Sorry about that. Go ahead.
The overall parcel, which includes that shopping center to the south, is the 11.7
.74 acres. The area that's going to be developed is north of the long staff drain, and it's about 4.1 acres that's going to be affected by the development.
Okay. So I just have some minor comments. The one thing is a public sidewalk is required along Shaner Road that was missing on the plan that we had. No outdoor storage, rooftop equipment must be screened, and that's about it. The Macomb County Road Commission is allowing one access drive from Shaner Road, so I think that will have to be reconfigured. Also, there wasn't a location for a ground sign, so maybe we might want to consider where you would locate that, because it looks like there's not that much opportunity for a ground sign, so maybe you could look at it in depth before you submit the plan. But other than that, there are no issues, Chairman.
Okay. Any commissioners have any questions or comments?
Mr. Chairman.
Who is that? Mr.
Lynn? Me.
Go ahead.
Is this a speculative, or do you have tenants in mind already?
We do have interest, nothing that's a firm deal. But so right now it is speculative.
Okay. Just curious.
Any other questions? Hearing none, a motion would be in order.
Mr. Chairman.
Go ahead, Mr. Appone.
Move to approve site plan number 19-44, Maria DiAgostini, DiAgostini Land Company, for Shaner South, parcel number 23-07-13-300-020, subject to submission and a revised site plan addressing all department and engineering comments.
Support.
Motion by Commissioner Appone, supported by Commissioner Moore. Any questions on the motion? Hearing none, Commissioner Appone.
Yes.
Commissioner Moore.
Yes.
Commissioner Flynn.
Yes.
Commissioner DeSico.
Yes.
Commissioner Gonzalez.
Yes.
Chair votes yes. You're all set.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Can you sign that sign-in sheet? Thank you.
Next item on our agenda is site plan number 19-38, Giovanni Gaglio, foreign and domestic collision, 8141 Millis. This is the northeast side of Millis, east side of Van Dyke. Addition to an existing collision shop and site improvements, a re-review.
Good evening. I'm Giovanni Gaglio. This is my father, the owner of foreign and domestic collision.
Mm-hmm.
So
my son has represented the shop, 8141 Millis.
Mm-hmm.
So he's been planning all this, you know, for the shop, the building and all that. So he's been doing a lot, and he's going to
walk you through some of the comments. So since we had last met, we taken a lot of your comments into consideration. Since we had last met, the first thing we had did was took the road commission comment into consideration. We met with the road commission shortly after in regards to the right-of-way that is currently paved along the north side of Millis Road. That pavement is actually in the road commission's right-of-way, and we currently park some of the vehicles, some of our employee vehicles along there right now. The road commission didn't like the fact that we parked there, and they didn't like the fact that it was pavement being utilized, you know, for a lot of our parking. So they're asking us to remove the pavement and turn that into grass. So since then we updated our plot plans, our engineering plans, to show the removal of the concrete and adding grass and some trees to coincide with some of the road commission's considerations. We also, since then, we've updated our plot plans to show the actual size of the septic, because last time we had met, there was a lot of concern with parking on our septic field. So since then, we've identified, we've put the septic field to scale. We do not park on it. We store parts on it. I've also included some pictures of the land currently. And we've also removed a construction storage trailer that was on the property that we use for parts and storage. We also, in doing so and updating some of the plans, we've identified cars that can be parked within the lot. It was asked that, you know, how many cars could we park comfortably in the lot, and I believe the plan came out to 17 cars in the lot, and that's excluding parking on the septic field. Like I said, we did move the construction trailer, and even though, you know, since then, we updated the plots to remove that existing concrete, and we still meet the minimum parking requirement currently, even with the removal of that asphalt. However, since we are currently utilizing that asphalt, it kind of made a concern to me that, you know, hey, we have enough parking here to do this addition. However, you know, we use that currently. So I went to my neighbor next door to see if he was in favor of, you know, some type of shared parking agreement, because he has a huge parcel on a lot of parking. And I would say I would need, you know, at most four spaces. So we put together a shared parking agreement, which he was fine with signing. And I'm just kind of going off some past comments that was brought up at the last meeting. Some other comments were in regards to our business, from looking at the addition from a business standpoint. The addition for us is not so much to grow in sales or to put out more business. We're mainly trying to do this addition to create more efficiency within the shop. Our shop, when you pull two vehicles in, they are almost, you know, bumper to bumper within the facility, you know, two cars deep. And it's just from a efficiency standpoint. I mean, I know you guys are not in the business of collision work, but I could kind of give you a brief example. You know, where we run into a lot is, you know, we pull a car in, and let's say we got to repair the bumper, right? We remove the bumper. We pull the car in, remove the bumper to repair something on it. We got parts everywhere. Well, now we in some cases have to take this car out from where the spot we were working on it, put it out in the lot, work on the bumper, pull another car in where there's parts for that vehicle that we're working on. It would just be nice to pull a vehicle in, tear it down, do the repairs, and reassemble it in that same spot, which happens very, very little in our facility. So that's why we really need the addition as far as adding value in that example. We also considered having more space, considered some new hires. We would probably consider hiring one more person to kind of help facilitate, just more of a laborer to help kind of move things along, wash cars, detail everything. That's kind of about it. We tried to address a lot of the stuff that was brought up last meeting. You know, we were just hoping you guys would take some of my comments into consideration and understand the value and need of this. And not only, it would also, you know, make it more appealing to the community and hopefully encourage some of our neighbors to do the same to their structures and properties.
All right, before I say anything else, Nick, you did the review on this. Can you let us know your report?
Yes. So, like Mr. Gaglio said, this is the third time it's been in front of the Planning Commission. So most of my comments would be reiterated, but the two main ones would be that you require a variance if this were to get approved. Two variances, actually. One, to allow the building to infringe upon the front yard setback, which it's really just meeting the building envelope that already exists. It's just bringing it forward to that where that shop or the office space is, and then to allow for front yard fencing where the fence already exists, but you're going to add a screening material to it to kind of hide the outdoor storage in the yard. Other than that, the biggest issue with this is the parking within the yard itself. The area you identified in the northwest corner of the property on the reserve septic field, that area can't be paved over, so you can't park cars there. All the parked cars need to be put on paved areas. So you'll lose those parking spots as far as your calculation goes. Other than that, I mean, if you can fit those cars within there the way you've laid them out, it works for me. I actually visited the site a few hours ago, and there was quite a few more cars on the site than what were in this picture.
Right.
So is that just for temporary?
It just, I mean, we worked up until we got here. So when we're in, you know, work in process, everything is, you know, I mean, we're moving cars.
Shifting cars around.
And part of the reason is because we don't have this space. It's constantly, we tear down a car, we got to pull it out. It's like we can't finish the car, you know, that was pulled in. So we put it out, put another, I mean, it's just a constant juggle of cars, which in a perfect collision shop, it should be you pull the vehicles in, work on them, tear them down, fix them, and pull it out, and the car is done, washed clean. I mean, it's, so we even have trouble washing sometimes within the shop when it's cold out, because it's so small, you know, within the building. So we sometimes wash outside, and sometimes it's freezing outside, you know, so it doesn't make a good.
The shop has been there 35 years. It used to be foreign domestic years ago and all that, and Joe and Mary Sorsitano used to own it. The thing about it is that shop was made so small, and with this addition we're doing, it's going to help us a lot. Just with cars that we leave inside and work on them, you know. And we change a lot of stuff. We put a brand new booth in there, costing $74,000, which is DeVelva's. They had a DeVelva's booth in there, an old timer. It was about 25, 30 years old, you know. So we improved that, and when we first moved in, the city of Shelby, I made everything by whatever they wanted, you know. I put a ramp for the handicap and all that. I put a railing to go downstairs in the basement. I did everything right, you know. So we've improved the roof. We put a new roof in, new parking lot. I did a lot. Spent a lot of money since I've been in Shelby Township. And I lived in Shelby Township over 15, 20 years. I used to live down the street in Power Square also, you know. So when I first got this building, I upgraded a lot, you know. I spent a lot of money on this building. The reason I want to do this is for my kids to upgrade and make it better for them. You know, so it's not about the parking spots and all that. We can eliminate that, that's fine. But we still need a fence on the side of Millis Road. You know?
Yeah, that's going to be, we're just improving that.
But everything else, we approved with the pool store next door. They'll let us park there if we need more parking space. That's fine with them, you know. We got to agree with them also.
So if this was approved and you're able to expand the building toward Millis Road, you would still have the parking spaces in front of the bays, but
correct.
There would not be any cars being worked on or any cars scheduled to be worked on parking in there, correct? That would only
correct.
Be customer parking.
Correct.
Customer, yeah.
Okay. I mean,
sorry. Well, I look at it like this. You know, you've been here three times. We certainly don't want to stand in the way of your business, and you're
right.
Expanding the business and making the property better. Each time you've been here, I've been very consistent that the property or that the business that you said was built 35 years ago, looking at it today, somebody could argue it's overbuilt. Now, the pictures you provided are nice, but I was out there yesterday. And they had cars double parked, triple parked, all the way out to where they were hanging out into Millis. I pulled in and then backed out, and I could barely see any traffic coming down Millis when I was backing out. So it's an issue. You know, Mr. Moffitt had asked that you show on your plan where you're going to park the cars.
Mm-hmm.
And because the way they were, it was a haphazard, disorganized, you know, parking arrangement. Even on your plan, you've shown parking where you want to put it, where it can't be put. Now, we had asked you about getting some kind of an agreement with the neighbor to your north. Is that the one you were talking about, or you just have one with pools of go-go to the south?
Just to the south.
Because the north is right across your property line. They've got a big parking lot.
They do.
Logistically, it seems better to do it that way than going...
The property to the north, the parking behind the building.
The north. I mean, the... You know, you said the issue is not with the parking. I would kind of dispute that because that's a big problem. And if you eliminate these four spaces and then you take away the parking that you have along Millis, which is in the right-of-way, you're going to have an even worse problem.
Right.
I don't, maybe some other commissioners can maybe come up with different opinion to convince me, but I'm not convinced based on what I've seen. I'm sympathetic to what you're trying to do, but I'm not convinced that the plan can be built. You're trying to squeeze it in, and I commend you for that, but I'm just not sure that this, I'll put it this way. Maybe your business is so successful that it's time that you get into a larger business somewhere else in the township. I mean, that's just how I'm looking at it. I'm not telling you to move, but I'm saying, yeah, obviously you're successful, and if you expand it, right.
Yeah, 9 mile chainer. I had a 6,500 square feet building. I had a mechanical facility and all that set up. It was a big building. We had a spray boot in there. We had a big parking lot also, you know. But the problem with that building was we had no parking for customers. It was 9 mile, and the fence was butt up to the sidewalk, and it was kind of bad. And Millis Road, thing about those trucks coming by there, semis. I don't know if you noticed when pools to go, they drop the pools equipment all off. There's semis coming through there no matter what. They take a swing, no matter what. They go right in my parking lot and then make that turn. And they make it. Big semis go through right through there every couple weeks.
Yeah, I commend you for what you're doing, but maybe some other commissioners have a different viewpoint. I'm just concerned that if we do this, what precedent might set going forward, and what other issues it might create on Millis. It could become something where it becomes an enforcement problem, where you're getting tickets all the time because the cars are parked out into the street. I don't know. That's what I'm looking at.
Well, couple
I'm just
things.
Speaking for myself, so
I understand. A couple things. You know, we visited before coming here and before putting together that shared parking agreement. We've touched base with all the surrounding commercial property owners, and they were all for having a shared park agreement. It just, to me, it made sense. There's no fence. There's no change in elevation. As far as for an employee or a customer or even one of us to walk from Pools of Go-Go to our facility, it's a short distance. There's nothing really in the way. The problem with the parking behind us, which is a huge lot, and I believe a physical therapist just purchased the building, which a small building like that, being a physical therapist, I doubt they're ever going to fill that lot. They might have maybe four cars there at a time. It just, from the behind our building, the backside, there's probably a 4-foot change in elevation. There's a fence with no gate. It just didn't seem as practical for me when I kind of analyzed the parking situation. And, you know, you could drive by there sometimes during the day, during a work day, and it is hectic. I mean, we work on vehicles. We're not working on, you know, something that could fit in your hand. And like I gave that example of pulling a bumper off or tearing a car down, you know, and then we pull it out. It's not like we could, I can't even develop a system to where I could tear down the car and put it in the lot, because then I got to juggle a bunch of cars out to get it out when that part is painted or a new part comes in. A perfect situation, again, would be have your cars in a lot that are not started, have the front area clean parking for customer parking, and as I mentioned before, customers don't wait here. When you get in a car accident, I mean, your car's here for a week minimum, you know. Ideal situation would have, you know, these customers pull up, the cars that are going to be worked on, brought directly in the lot. The cars that are worked on are in the building, and they don't come out until they're done. Right, versus right now, it's chaotic. I mean, like you said, you pull up there during the day. We're constantly, if you stood there all day, we're pulling cars. I mean, obviously, we do finish cars. We finish cars, but we are pulling cars that are half done, in primer, out into the lot, and parking them up front in that chaotic parking area, because I'm hesitant to put them in the lot, in the storage lot, because I'm going to need them out the next day, right? Or the next morning. So I'm going to put it in the lot, then I'm going to jam it in there with another customer that's not an approved insurance job or not an approved job, and now I got to take that car out to get my other car that I started. It just, that's why it's not necessarily we're storing these cars. Those cars there are a work in process, you know. They should be in the building, but they're not. We don't have the space. So it would be clean up there. And the cars, that we finished, we would, you know, potentially put into Pools of Go-Go parking lot or something that it's just done when the customer pulls in, when they get dropped off by a rental service. I'll go get their car pulled around, they jump in, and they leave. It just, in itself, it just creates chaos. You know, you cannot plan, no matter how, I'm a planning freak, you know, when I'm trying to run on a day-to-day basis, and it just, it makes it very, very difficult. Because first off, you're dealing with something as big as a car, and it just you can't put a work in process vehicle behind a vehicle that's not approved, or you know, vice versa. I mean, it just
okay. Let me interrupt you. You're kind of going in circles at this point. I get what you're saying, and I think, Mr. Chairman, if I may, basically, you're talking about having cars that would normally be outside inside. So
inside.
You're not talking about adding additional cars, you're just talking about having these cars inside the building. I get that. Your plan doesn't, my only concern, because this is not right on Van Dyke Mills, is kind of a side street, mm-hmm. is you mentioned something about the ripping up of the asphalt and putting in a green belt, and that doesn't seem to be shown on any of these plans.
It's on there.
Where am I looking at it here? So this all this, but this would still be
correct.
Okay.
So
the area in the satellite photo where you're showing a car that is in the right of way, that would be green belt.
Correct. So if you
picture here.
Correct. So okay. Fence line along Mills, the right of way is about splits that car in half. So our property really starts probably in the middle of that car you see from a satellite view.
Mr. Chairman, I share some of your concerns. However, in these close call cases, and I think this is one of those close call cases, I personally would tend to come down more on the side of the applicant, because you're big boys. Mm-hmm. It's your money, and you know if you get this approved and you start putting cars in the right of way, we're going to write you tickets and you're going to be paying them. But you're the one that gets to make that judgment call. You know, if it's a close call, I'm going to let you make that judgment call because it's your business. But you need to be aware that the days of slacked enforcement in Shelby Township in terms of things that might aggravate the neighbors or the road commission are over. 35 years ago when you came into town, it was Wild Wild West. I know that, and you know, do whatever you want. Ask for forgiveness later. That doesn't go on anymore. So, I would be inclined to approve this, Mr. Chairman, subject to the variances that they need, and subject to them putting in that berm, so the road commission is happy, and there's less risk of them putting cars in the right of way. Because I think it's kind of a, and he's explained it several times, it's kind of a neutral proposition in terms of the number of automobiles, because the cars are now going to be parked inside instead of outside. So really he's just asking for, you know, a carport with four walls on it so that he can do what he's doing. So, and it sounds like he's made quite a bit of investment. And I know in this economy, there's no way he's going to be able to find a building this size for probably what he can afford to or wants to spend. So he's probably stuck in many ways doing this expansion or doing nothing, because it's, I would guarantee it's cost prohibitive to duplicate this building somewhere else in the township, being grandfathered in as he is. And again, on these close call situations, I would tend to come back on the side of the long-term residents.
So is that a motion, Mr. Flynn?
It can be if you want one. I would move to move to approve site plan 1938 Giovanni Gaglio, 8141 Millis, parcel 2307271020032, located north of Millis on the east of Van Dyke, subject to the submission of a revised site plan addressing all department comments and the granting of applicable variances.
Support.
Motion by Commissioner Flynn, supported by Commissioner Appone. Any questions on the motion? Hearing none, Commissioner Flynn?
Yes.
Commissioner Appone?
Yes.
Commissioner DeSico? Commissioner Gonzalez?
Yes.
Commissioner Moore?
Yes.
Chair votes no. Motion carries. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Good luck, guys. And I appreciate, as I think we all do, because we're all residents, we appreciate you investing in the community and employing people. That's a good thing, too.
All right.
Make sure you sign in, too, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. one closing.
Well, the gal in front of you, DiAgostini, ask her what she wants for that 8,000 square foot building.
What's that?
Ask her what she, the
people who had the
yeah, for that 8,000 square feet, I bet you it's a few commas involved.
Sure. You want to make another comment?
Just one last comment, you know, and I understand a lot of you have been by our business. If you go by during the day, you see what I'm talking about. But as far as right now, you drive by at night, I mean, everything's tightened up at night. It's like I said, when one's work in process, it's chaos. At night, everything's back to how it should be, as in the picture. So.
Well, good luck. I hope it works out for you anyway. So.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, next item, site plan number 20-01 for Peter Burton, Conrad Schwee for Magna Foam Systems, 6226 Mile Road, south side of 26 Mile, east of Shelby Industrial Building Addition.
Evening.
Hello.
Hi. Before I start, would you mind if I hand out an aerial photo?
Sure.
This is probably orient.
Here, you can hand it here. I'll pass them down. Whatever. Okay.
Sure.
That's fine.
Thanks. Thank you.
Okay. So, good evening. My name is Conrad Schwee. I'm here on behalf of the applicant, the owner of the property, which is BKG 6226 Mile LLC, but really that's an entity that Burton Katzman, it's a real estate development company, owns. And Magna is our tenant. So I'm Matt Finneran. He's the assistant general manager over at that facility. And he's been there since it was, what, Lear? Or
SIA.
Since it was a first SIA facility. And now it's a Magna Foam Systems building. So Magna currently has two foam injection molding systems within the facility. They have plans to install a third, just because they're doing a lot of work and they make on the order of hundreds of thousands of seats a year. I mean, what's the
6.5 million?
So I was off by a little bit. So they make a lot of seats,
yeah.
There. So they're continuing their trajectory of growth, and for a lot of reasons, this facility is the best fit for them. So we're proposing about a 30,800 square foot addition to the south and east of the existing building. It's about a $3.5 million construction project. Right now they have close to 170 full-time jobs in that facility. And if we do the addition and they add that third line, it'll add about 65 jobs. So, you know, they're a good tenant. They're a good, you know, they're a good customer of ours, and you know they're a key part of the sort of just-in-time, you know, automotive supply chain here in Detroit. And I'm sure Julie will get into it, but we've got the 30,000 square foot addition here. We've got parking added to the extent we can. We recognize that we're about 14 spaces short per the zoning ordinance, and the tenant obviously doesn't want to create a situation where they can't park their employees because, you know, they function there day in, day out. So they've got a plan where they stagger shifts. And we see this at a lot of our manufacturing plants. Instead of 100% of the people leaving and going home and 100% coming in, where you kind of double your, you know, you have a peak load of 200% at that point, they stagger it. So half the people leave. Couple hours later, another half leaves, so it staggers it, so your peak is really about 150% of your peak demand. So when they calculate it out, they need 132 parking spaces. We've got 156 on the plan. So us as a landlord, we don't want a situation that doesn't work for the tenant either. So there's that. The screen wall along the east side at the condominiums, you can see it there down at the southeast corner. There's a practical reason why we can't build the wall. There's a 12-foot wide existing storm sewer easement that drains into the pond where we pick up the storm water from the property to the south. Those three industrial buildings flow into our pond. So there's an easement there and a pipe there, and we can't build a wall on top of that. From a planning perspective, I got a planning degree. I was on a planning commission in Plymouth for 10 years, so hats off to you planning commissioners. From a planning perspective, I've been in this situation where there's walls and various ways to screen things. If you look at that photo, I mean, that wall would be 60, 70 feet from the condominiums there. And if you notice, it's really the clubhouse and the pool are the most impacted in their detention pond. There is the one building of the condominium. We'd be building a wall roughly 70 feet away from there, which is probably not a great addition to their view. There's already the wall they can see of the property to our south, which is maybe 100 feet away. Our building is about 235 feet from the property line. So what we're proposing is, for one, I can't build a wall there anyhow, but two, to just add some more screening on our side to get a good evergreen cover of, you know, a screen wall there. The third variance is the truck docks are currently on the north side of the building. There's six of them there. They've been there forever. And for their kind of logistics processes, they really need to add a seventh dock. So we're expanding that existing condition to add that seventh dock in the front setback, which is Mound Road. In addition, just because of the just-in-time nature of all the in-and-out logistics they have, proposing to add two trailer parking spaces to the east of the addition, and they're a little south. So those two trailers would park actually so that they're south of the existing north wall of the building, kind of be snug back there. We've got that shown on the plans as a future phase of work for the simple reason that we anticipate that the engineering reviews of anything that we're doing to modify that drain easement, the Shockey drain there, will probably take some more time as opposed to the underlying engineering and permitting for the building. So we've intentionally separated that work that would impact the drain as a separate phase just so we can kind of permit those separately. So that's why that's there. And the last variance, and I know you're not the ZBA, but it just can come up, is for the rooftop screening. Again, I mean, so the existing building, there's not a lot of equipment on the roof because they're pre-engineered metal buildings, so most of the equipment wants to sit on the ground. We will have four pieces of equipment on the addition. The closest one is going to be about 275, 280 feet from the property line. And again, we're screening it with additional evergreen trees. And the way that building slopes, it's a little counterintuitive. It actually slopes as it gets lower towards the east. So the high point goes east-west. You'd think it is kind of north-south. So the lowest point of the building will actually be facing the east there. So the slope goes down. So for those reasons, you know, we've requested those four variances that are there. But from a planning perspective and the zoning ordinance, and again, correct me if I'm wrong, I think we meet the ordinance other than those issues that I just mentioned, probably the most significant being the parking, and we're comfortable with that from an operational standpoint on the tenant side. The other thing is we are proposing to tie our parking lot, well, our expanded parking lot, to the neighbor's property to the south and exit out onto Mound Road. There's an easement in place. I provided a copy, and I can get those to everybody, but there's an easement in place. There was a bit of a horse trade when our building was built and the three buildings to the south were built. The arrangement was that our site would pick up the storm water for the three buildings to the south. They don't have a detention pond. It outflows in our detention pond. And we would get an irrevocable, non-exclusive easement to tie into their driveway to access Mound Road. So that's our plan. And because all the trucks are in the north there right now, you know, when a truck's pulling in, if any of you can imagine a truck driver trying to back up and it's in the middle of their parking lot, their employees can't get in or out. So that's a key factor and improvement to the site plan, is to allow that access to Mound Road to sort of disperse traffic a little bit and ease the issue of trucks blocking the driveway in and out. So with that, I'll turn it over to any questions or anything else.
All right, Julie, your report.
Okay, so as Mr. Shuey described, there was the four variances that were this site plan required. And the reduction in minimum parking requirements, actually, I don't have a problem with. So if they're going to be staggering their employees, clearly then they won't need all that parking. And if they can make it work for their operations, then I'm not opposed to that. The landscaping, I'm satisfied in with them installing more landscaping, because clearly you can't build the wall in the drain easement or the sewer easement. So there's really, it's going to be, you know, difficult to overcome. Plus, it's over 236 feet from the property line. So adding additional landscaping to provide that screening is acceptable. The outdoor trailer parking and the garage in front, or the overhead doors, the loading and unloading, I mean, the doors are already there. I don't see an issue with adding one more door there. The only thing that I have is the rooftop equipment. So the units are going to be located at the southeast portion of that building as well. And I guess I would suggest maybe if we, I don't have a problem with eliminating the rooftop equipment screening on the south side of the building, but along the east side of the building, I think it would make sense to screen the residents from that development to the east and the north side, because it's a long 26 mile there.
Is that a problem, screening on the east?
Not really. So, again, putting on my planner hat, those screens, sometimes they make what they're they're way worse than what they're hiding. Like, let's say you're hiding something that's 6 foot by 6 foot, and what we'll do is we'll just put an 8 foot by 8 foot screen in front of it, and people go, what's that huge thing? Because I just ran in this building we built in Auburn Hills, so you could see a couple of the rooftop units from one particular angle, and we put on a screening, and now there's these two huge things on a roof that block it. I think from the north, the drainage easement is heavily wooded. You can't, you won't be able to see the building from the north. In the south, we have the industrial building. But the east side of those couple units that are on the east, they're not very big. They're pretty low. And they're far enough back from the edge that you probably can't see them back there anyhow. But the screening from the east, I don't have an issue with that.
Okay. Is that it, Julie?
That's it.
Any commissioners have any questions or comments?
Mr. Chairman.
Go ahead, Mr. Flynn.
Is this a 24-hour operation?
Yes, it is.
Julie, any concerns about light pollution?
No, they have to provide shielding for all the light, the building fixtures, and if there's any light poles. But it doesn't seem that there's any parking on that side of the building anyway, so it would be along Mound Road is where a majority of the parking is.
Okay. Yeah, and I agree that from a community standpoint, I'd rather have natural, we were talking about it with Nick today, I'd rather have natural screening than a big wall anyway. So that sounds good to me. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Sure thing. Anybody else? Hearing none, the motion would be in order.
Mr. Chair, I'd like to make a motion to approve site plans 20-01 for Conrad M. Shuey for Magna Foam Systems, subject to the submission of a revised site plan addressing all department and engineers' comments and attaining all required variances.
Support.
Motion by Commissioner DeCicco, supported by Commissioner Moore. Any questions on the motion? Hearing none. Commissioner DeCicco?
Yes.
Commissioner Moore?
Yes.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Yes.
Commissioner Flynn?
Yes.
Commissioner Appone?
Yes.
And Chair votes yes. Motion carries.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
And all the staff at all the departments have been fantastic, too, by the way.
Great to hear.
Building department, Tim Wood.
Okay, our last site plan for this evening is number 20-02. Ronnie Georges for Rio Banquet Hall, 45660 Mound Road, located at the southeast corner of West Utica and Mound Road, site improvements.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Safe Case Mika on behalf of Ronnie Georges and Rio Banquet Hall. At this point, there have been, you know, they've been in the process of obtaining the site, you know, site improvements from the from Shelby Township, and have gone through, other processes such as, water, health department, and this is going to be a banquet hall, restaurant and as well. So we're here to, answer any questions, obviously, regarding the banquet hall and to see if there are, what the timeline would be for approval and implementation for the site, improvements.
Okay. Nick, you got a report this time, so go ahead.
Yes. This site plan is pretty straightforward. It's a simple landscaping plan. All the trees and shrubs, they're all recommended by the township, so that falls within line there. My biggest concern was addressed by the Macomb County Department of Roads. That right-of-way on the northwest part of the property where there's parking currently. The site plan calls it out saying there won't be any parking there. That's good, but the Macomb County Roads requires that that area be removed for parking. So you got to extend the curb there, add a green belt, you know, grass, what have you. But just indicate that in the site plan, and
sure,
that'll solve that issue.
Okay.
And then the other item was that there were bumper blocks identified in the site plan.
Okay.
Those aren't permitted within Shelby Township, so just remove those. I noted that on the site plan, it looks like the trash enclosures kind of got four walls on the side. I went and visited the site. There's a gate. Just signified there's a gate with that trash enclosure on the site plan.
Okay.
And that's all I have.
And the parking on the north side that the road commission says it's in the right-of-way, their recommendation was that those blocked by relocating some parking bumpers so people won't park there. I mean, this building has gone through a lot of redevelopment over the years. Different restaurants have been there, and old habits die hard. I think if you just put up a sign, it may not do it. Is there anything you can do to make sure that that parking is not utilized?
I mean, putting up a sign or any recommendations, you know, by this body or by the commission is something that is not going to be too cumbersome.
Well, they're recommending putting relocating parking bumpers so they cannot access that. And maybe that area, once you do that, you can add some landscaping to that section. While we're on the subject of improvements, is there any plan you have to spruce up the building through painting or any kind of aesthetic improvements to the outside?
Yes. I mean, painting on the inside will be part
outside.
Of
outside.
Oh, for the outside?
Outside, yeah.
For the outside, it's not clear at this time, but I mean, once we actually get the approval for site improvements, I mean, the plan is to be able to spruce up the building overall. I mean, to make the building aesthetically attractive, mm-hmm. both outside and inside. I mean, it's going to be, you know, a social function, a banquet hall, a restaurant. So the plan would be to make it aesthetically both outside and inside.
Okay, so I take that as a yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Correct.
Any other commissioners have any questions or comments? Okay, hearing none, motion would be in order.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead, Commissioner Moore.
I move to approve site plan 20-02, Ronnie Gorgas, Rio Banquet Hall, 45660 Mound Road, parcel number 23-07-33-351-001, located south of West Utica Road and east of Mound Road, subject to the submission of a revised site plan addressing all department comments.
Is there support?
Support.
Support by Commissioner DeCicco. Any questions on the motion? Hearing none. Commissioner Moore?
Yes.
Commissioner DeCicco?
Yes.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Yes.
Commissioner Flynn?
Yes.
Commissioner Oppone?
Yes.
Chair votes yes. You're all set. Thank you.
Just a quick question, and client,
sure.
Let us know, is there's a timeline for, you know, any kind of receiving this in writing, whether regarding both the approval and any suggestions?
Julie?
Well, you'll get a copy of the draft minutes, and you'll make your corrections to the site plan. So you'll have 2 years once the site plan has been signed.
Okay.
Okay.
When we'd receive those minutes?
You should get them in about a week.
Okay. Thank okay. you.
Make sure you sign in, too, please.
Oh,
thank you.
Yep.
No one here for old business, no one here for new business. Julie, do you have anything?
Yes, February 10th meeting has been canceled.
All right. Anything else?
Nope, that's it.
All right, that's it. Mr. Dallow's not here. Who'd like to make a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Support.
It's been moved and seconded to adjourn. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Good night, everyone.
Among Shelby Township's greatest assets are the world-class recreational opportunities it provides to residents. Within its borders, the township offers more than 1,100 acres in township parks, sports fields, playgrounds, and trails. Shelby Township provides an escape for nature lovers with many of its parks. Home to more than 100 species of native birds and animals, including nesting American bald eagles, and more than 80 species of trees, shrubs, wildflowers, it's hard not to fall for the township's beauty. Along with its parks and recreation facilities and programs, Shelby Township is home to Cherry Creek Golf Club, one of the finest public golf and banquet destinations in Michigan. The township also shares the 4,000-acre Stony Creek Metro Park, which is home to the beautiful and tranquil 500-acre Stony Creek Lake. Shelby Township also hosts part of the Macomb Orchard Trail, a 24-mile hike and bike path that connects 180 miles of trails across southeastern Michigan. Shelby Township's parks and access to the Clinton River are the heart of what makes the township a better place to play. Add the township's hundreds of miles of hiking and biking trails, and it's easy to recognize Shelby Township's access and opportunity for recreation are like no other places in the region. Among these trails is the westernmost portion of the Macomb Orchard Trail, which spans from the township's western border and ends in downtown Richmond. There are also trails that connect the township's 800-acre Riverbends Park to Lake St. Clair. Shelby Township is also home to a key connection of the Macomb County 70-mile trail loop and the planned Iron Bell bike trail, which will ultimately connect the city of Detroit to the state of Wisconsin. Shelby Township's trails offer residents and visitors a scenic mix of up north hikes and great asphalt bike paths. All of these amenities ensure that no matter what your outdoor interests might be, there is a place in Shelby Township for you and your family. A better place. Thank you.